I come alive. I need to be free with you tonight. I need your love.
I first started in photography when I inherited my DSLR. It was a Nikon D90 that allowed me to further explore the hobby of photography. I also inherited the TriggerTrap, which was a device that contained a lot of features that introduces you to many photography aspects. My work has started off very rough, just take the photos, produce the video, and then that's it. Now I've begun to incorporate music and transitions, and now it's a very smooth process. I first start by identifying the location I'm going to shoot from, either by using the Melways or Google Maps. I then pick my point of interest. I use Street View on Google Maps just to identify whether it's a good location, what point I can actually shoot from, and then I travel there by a bike or public transport. When I first get to my location, I unpack my bag, I then set up my tripod and mount my camera to my tripod. I then make sure all the settings on my DSLR are set for a time-lapse. This starts with turning image stabilizer off, autofocus off, and white balance auto off. And then I change the rest of the settings depending on the location. I then take out my TriggerTrap, plug it into my camera, and make sure the interval is set to whatever I want. So 3 seconds or 5 seconds is usually what I commonly go for. I then press start and then just sit back and relax. After doing that a few times at different locations, my workflow process starts when I copy all my photos from my camera to my computer. I then use SNS HDR to create high dynamic range photos. I continue to use Lightroom to import my photos, and then use LR time-lapse to reduce flicker and any bulk corrections I want to do. I then import the metadata from LR time-lapse in Lightroom and then make corrections on a single frame and then propagate those changes through the rest of the photos. I then export out of Lightroom and then import into Premiere. Then import all the photos as a sequence into Premiere, and then apply music, intro credits, outro credits, transitions, and then I export a video. all the hard work done, all that is left is to publish. I publish my videos to Vimeo, YouTube, and Tumblr. And that's where the end result is now.